It's Friday, April 24th, 2015. Hello, I'm Veronique Masterson. Here's what you need to know about what's happening at the University of Texas at El Paso. Congratulations to the UTEP Center for Inland Desalination Systems team, who placed second in the Desal Prize Challenge. They won $60,000 for their machine that uses a new electrodialysis technology that greatly reduces the amount of wastewater associated with current desalination practices. The top three teams will move on to compete for $400,000 in USAID grants to pilot their technologies in a developing country. Congratulations also to UTEP students at the Prospector Daily, and Minero magazine. They were honored with 23 awards at the annual Texas Intercollegiate Press Association's Spring Convention earlier this month. The Prospector won 11 awards, the online student newspaper The Prospector Daily received 5 awards, and Minero magazine won 7 awards. UTEP researchers are developing a computer-aided detection system that would predict if and when breast cancer will appear. According to electrical engineer Dr. Wei Kyung, who runs UTEP's Medical Imaging Informatics Lab, the research is expected to save some women from getting unnecessary annual mammograms. In a paper published in the journal Computerized Medical Imaging and Graphics, the team's system had an accuracy of 70% when it came to predicting which women would develop breast cancer by their next mammogram and which women would not. The technology would calculate overall density and highlight any suspicious areas that are extremely dense. It would also alert the doctor about any differences between the two breasts. Don't forget to check out Florafest this weekend. The region's largest native plant sale opens at 9 a.m. Saturday and Sunday at the Centennial Museum and Chihuahuan Desert Gardens. Tonight, you can browse the plants and attend Tough Beauty, Remarkable Plant Life of the Big Bend, a lecture by Gary Norwood, an avid photographer and blogger of the Big Bend. The free presentation begins at 6 p.m. in room 106 of the Undergraduate Learning Center. Last Saturday, thousands celebrated the opening of Centennial Plaza and the Lekang in the heart of the UTEP campus. The open, pedestrian-friendly plaza is the centerpiece of the university's campus transformation plan.
Centennial Plaza, it is and will always be a site that represents a huge gift to all of us on the campus now and all of those who will follow in our footsteps over the next century.
The 11-acre site incorporates arroyos, drought-resistant vegetation, rock structures, and a natural amphitheater. It is also home to the intricately hand-carved, hand-painted Lekang, which the people of Bhutan gave to the people of the United States in 2008 with a request that it be permanently installed at UTEP. Tours of the Lekang are by appointment only and in groups. For more information about these and other stories, check out utepnews.com. I'm Veronique Masterson. We'll see you next Friday. Go Miners!